Hello friends, today's demo is about a unique requirement that I have got from one of my clients, wherein today, as per their planning process or their production process, they generate planned orders in S4 system based on which destination location they are supposed to go. Till date, they were using a custom ERP, and that ERP used to generate the net requirement and then used to split that net requirement into separate planned orders, and each planned orders had a particular destination mapped to it with a particular quantity, so that they have the mapping of which planned order needs to go to which destination DC, so that once the production completes, they can package and transport that particular quantity to the destination location. And the requirement is to map that particular solution in IBP time series planning. Now here, there are two parts to the solution. One is integrating time series based planned orders to S4, for which we have standard baddies through which we can export or integrate production plan generated in IBP and integrate them into S4. Now, where the things goes different here in this development is, in this requirement, we have to leverage heuristics or optimizer to generate net requirement based on that optimizer or heuristic will create one production plan at a product location source ID level. And the customization that we need to do is to split that production plan based on the destination locations and then integrate those planned orders, or rather those splitted planned orders, into IBP with reference to which destination DC they are supposed to go. So for that purpose, we have done the development obviously using attribute transformation and then using CPIDS and leveraging the standard baddies to integrate planned orders from IBP time series to S4. Now, how the solution is working, this is what I'm going to show you. So if you refer to my screen, you will see we have a product called product 1 at a location 200, which is a factory. In this factory, we get demand from different DCs that comes as a dependent demand. And this factory itself also has independent demand because there are many customer requirements that comes directly to the factory from where they are directly replenished to the customer. So what you are seeing here in my screen is a result after a heuristic run, wherein if you see that the heuristics has generated a net requirement or net demand of 500, and based on this net demand or net requirement of 500, the heuristic has also generated a production plan for this product at the production version. Now, our objective is to split this planned order based on the dependent demand that is coming from individual DCs, and then split the planned orders equivalent to the supply that we are doing from this plant location to the respective DCs. So if you see here, you see we have a net demand of 500 with a production plan generated of 500 as well. Now, Here at this level, if you look, the demand, the net demand has been met with a production plan of 500, but the transport supply generated by the heuristics is 400. So that means at this level, I can look and say that although I have a net demand of 500 and I am sending only 400 of my production plan to different destination location, so that means the remaining delta 500 minus 400, which is 100, this is the requirement, or this will be the supply that is required to replenish the demand for the factory 200 itself. So till this key figure and the production plan, everything is standard and generated as a result of the heuristics or optimizer run. The customization that we have done comes here from this key figure, wherein first we are identifying if the production plan generated is to supply all of it to other destination location, or does the production plan also contains quantities which are meant to be replenished for the demand of the factory itself. So that is the reason, using a simple calculation here, we are identifying how much of the production plan is required to replenish the demand at the factory itself, which is 100, and the heuristics or the optimizer in a way after the run is telling me how much needs to be supplied to which location, which we can refer to the transportation supply key figure. Now here what we have done is we have used attribute transformation, wherein first I am taking a look into the heuristics or the optimizer output, wherein if you see the algorithm itself tells me how much of the quantity is being supplied to which destination location from this factory. So if you see, the transport supply of 150, 150 and 100 has been generated for this respective location, and the sum is 400. So that means for this production plan of 500, 400 are meant to be sent to each of this individual destination location, and 100 is meant for replenishment within the factory itself. So for that purpose, we have created attribute transformation first to generate total supply by destination and supply for forecast at the factory. So if you see here, the key figure total supply by destination basically splits that planned order of 500 based on my transport supply, which in a way tells me that out of the production plan of 500, 100 is meant to be for its own location, 200 to replenish its own demand, whereas for locations like 6211, 6231 or 6379, we have total supply by destination splitted, wherein we have splitted the planned orders in such a way that it matches to the supply that we are supposed to make at each individual destination. So this key figure supply for factory forecast DS, if you look into this forecast, into this key figure, you will see this key figure gets populated only where my location and my destination location are the same. So that means I am proportioning or splitting the planned order quantity in this key figure to denote that this much quantity of the planned order needs to be produced and stay in the factory itself to replenish its own demand. Whereas in the other key figure that is called total supply by destination, here you will see that I am populating not only the 100 that is supposed to stay here, but I am also populating and splitting the planned order based on the supply that is supposed to go in each destination location. Now, the next level of transformation that we need to do is to ensure that we extrapolate this number in a key figure where we have the product, the manufacturing location, the destination location along with the source ID, because the objective is to integrate these numbers back to S4. And in order to integrate planned orders into S4, I need three primary elements, which is the factory location, the product, and the product version or the source ID. So for that purpose, if I go and show you the next view, here you will see that the same numbers that are generated in this key figure called total supply by destination has been extrapolated using attribute transformation, wherein we have added the source ID, and based on this source ID now we have updated the number in a different key figure called production by destination. So instead of integrating the standard key figure production, we are integrating this custom key figure production by destination in S4. And in order to integrate that, I need the three primary elements, which are the location, the product, and the source ID. And apart from that, I need this additional information of the destination location, which I need to populate in a custom field in S4, which is being used today to identify the relationship of a planned order as to which location they are supposed to go. So here in this view, if you see, we are viewing this at a standard location product source ID level, where both the heuristics optimizer generated key figure production plan and the custom key figure that we have created can all be viewed or aggregated at the same level, and that's how we are able to integrate this custom key figure using CPIDS and the standard baddie to integrate planned orders back to S4. Now here what we are doing is we are taking the supply run generated planned production and then splitting that planned production here based on the supply that we are making in each distribution center that they are supposed to go, along with the production plan that is supposed to meet the demand for the factory itself. So in a way, this production plan of 500, we are splitting it automatically into different destination locations and also to the same factory location if that factory location is having its own demand. If a factory doesn't have its own direct demand, then my net demand and transport supply will always be the same, and supply for factory forecast will be zero. So by that we will know that the production plan for that factory is meant to be supplied exclusively to destination location, and there is no individual demand at the factory itself. But in this scenario, we do have demand at the factory. As a result of this, we need to split the production plan not only by the destination location but also by the factory itself, where it has its own demand to be fulfilled. So that's how we are splitting the system or the supply algorithm generated production plan in a custom key figure called production by destination, which we have developed using attribute transformation, and then we are integrating it to S4. Now, I am not going into the part of running SAP IDS and integrating it, but I will show you the end result, how the things looks after integration in S4. So, if I come into S4, I am here in this MD04 view, wherein, if you see, the planned orders that are generated by IBP has been splitted based on the split that we are having in that key figure production by destination, and instead of getting one planned order quantity of 500, here we are splitting that quantity into 100, 150, 150 and 100 each, and in each of this planned order, in the custom field, we are populating the destination location which we have here in IBP, through which they can have that mapping in S4, and they know which planned order is meant to be supplied for which destination location, so that once that planned order is converted into a production order and the production happens and the stocks are generated, they are packed and shipped and sent to the respective destination location for which they are meant. So in a way, partially, if you see, we are trying to accommodate to some extent a pegging relationship, wherein we are basically splitting planned order based on demand from each individual location, and then maintaining that relationship of the demand and supply, so that I know which production plan is meant to be supplied for which destination location, or even to the same factory itself. That's how, using those customization and the flexibility available in IBP, we are able to split the production plan based on the custom requirement of the client, and split the planned orders and send those splitted planned orders in S4 with the destination information or the destination location information in it, so that they can have that pegging relationship in S4. So that's all what I wanted to cover in this video today. So please do like and subscribe, and let me know your feedback, how you feel about this development, and if there is anything else that we could have added to make this solution more robust and even more flexible. Thank you. Thanks a lot for watching.